Hi, how are you? I showed you the view outside. It's evening and it's quite nice weather outside. As you can see the sky, and there were so many different colors. It's almost difficult, you know. I can say orange and yellowish, but there are more colors than I can describe. So here in this video, welcome back to my channel, and I hope you are good, fine, and I hope at least one person is there who is watching this video, and I want that person to be a good reader. And in this video, I will talk about the same book that is The Brother Karamazov by Fyodor Dostoevsky. It is one of the most famous novels of Dostoevsky. There are other famous novels as well, like Crime and Punishment and Idiot, and there is Possessed and Notes from the Underground, or Notes from the Dead House, and Gambler, or The Double. These are some of the novels that I have read. So here I will just discuss this book, and particularly chapter 6 and book 3. If you have read this book, you know that there are many characters, and there are characters like Ivan, who is an intellectual. There is Alyosha, who is a spiritual person, and there is Dmitri. These are three brothers. Dmitri is very passionate and sensualist, like his father Fyodor Pavlovich. So here I would love to talk about a character who I think is the most powerful characters of this novel, and who has inserted a kind of energy into this book and made this book famous in a different way, apart from the religious point of view. Here in this video, actually, I will just talk about chapter 6 and mostly about Smirnov's personality, what kind of personality he has, and what kind of childhood he has spent. First of all, I want to clear that Smirnov seems or looks like an atheist person, because in the childhood, when he was a kid, I'm telling you an instance when Grigori teaches him scriptures, religious scriptures, and then Smirnov asks him one question. He asks Grigori that if God created light on the first day, and sun, moon, and the stars on the fourth day, then how did the or where did the light come from on the first day? So this was his question. As we know that if sun was created on the fourth day, it is impossible to have light on the first day, because sun reflects like light, or sun is responsible for light. So his question is quite relevant, and but Grigori doesn't find this question delightful, and he immediately slaps Smirnov, and then Smirnov has a fit. It is an epileptic fit, and he suffers from these fits all his life until his demise. So this is one of the situations. As you can see, that's his religious observation, or religious point of view, or religious depth. Secondly, he doesn't have any particular interest in books as well. I want to clear this thing as well, that as Fyodor Pavlovich lives in a mansion or in a big house, and Smirnov lives in servants' quarters, where Grigori, his legal father, we should say, Marfa, and Smirnov lives. They live in a separate accommodation. So Smirnov once visits, as they he usually go there and goes there and serves his master Fyodor Pavlovich. He once sees Fyodor Pavlovich's bookcase, and there are so many books, almost 300 or 400, I'm not sure, maybe 100 books. But Fyodor Pavlovich never reads those books. So Smirnov is staring at that bookcase, and Fyodor Pavlovich sees Smirnov looking at the books, and he thinks that the child wants to read, and he hands over the keys of the bookcase to Smirnov, And then Smirnov starts reading some books. But after some times, he stops reading and he says that these books are boring. And Smirnov swears at him. And then it shows that Smirnov doesn't have any interest in books as well. He is quite a different person. Like in his childhood, there is an instance he would hang the cats in a nail, and when the cat is dead, he would bury them and do some ritual. So you can see how strange he is. Have you ever seen a child performing such ritual or playing with the cats in such a manner? I think I haven't seen. I have seen children playing different sorts of games, maybe worse or some absurd games, but this is quite different altogether, and it is quite bizarre or absurd in my opinion. Then his nature is, this is a different point about his personality. His nature is, you can say that, passive aggressive. Once, not once, many times when Grigory would beat Smirnov for different reasons, Smirnov would never react. He would just go in some corner, he would sit there, and he would lie there forever, and he would just internally agonize. He would never react actively because it was not his way of reaction. As you have seen that people also in life, there are kids, when you slap children, they sometimes react actively, or they will hit you back, or they will shout at you. But there are some children who will never react and they will suffer internally. So Smirnov was one of those children. And then this is very interesting. I titled this Intensive Contemplation. Smirnov would delve into deeper contemplation state. One example, when he would have his meal, like there is a bowl of soup and there is spoon. And he would look at the soup for minutes, like 20 minutes. He's just staring at the soup, and Grigory is looking at him, and Grigory is getting angry. But Smirnov is lost into his contemplation. Like he, you can see, juxtapose this situation with OCD, but OCD is obsessive compulsive disorder, and it is quite different. Contemplation is quite different. So Smirnov is staring at the soup, and then he puts his spoon into the bowl, and he takes the spoon, and then he looks the spoon again for some time. So he is kind of lost in this contemplative state. I found this very interesting. I don't know why, but this is quite strange. Like you are staring at a thing. I think it shows signs of intelligence in some way. Maybe some people find this absurd, but in my opinion, this behavior is strange in a very intellectual way. We can say that. I'm not sure. I may be rambling in this matter. But I will tell you one thing. It is just beside the subject. A few days back, I learned this thing, that there is a difference between thinking and contemplation. Earlier, I never bothered about both these terms, and I used to think that both these terms mean the same. But there is a difference in thinking and contemplation. Thinking means that we have a subject, and then we think about that subject within our mind. Like, if I want to think about my goals, then I will think about my career, and there is that subject in my mind. So my ideas will be restricted or limited to that point of view. But in contemplation, I won't have any subject. I will just stare at the wall, and I will just look at the wall and won't think about the thoughts but thoughts will come automatically. You can try this. Just stare at the wall and don't focus on any particular thought, and thoughts will come to you. Some random thoughts will be there, and this is contemplation. So this is stupid, I know, to explain all these things, but I found this very interesting and it opened up new dimension for me. So our next point is, I'm sorry, this earbud is quite loose, and there are, you know, so many different points that I want to talk about. I sometimes feel like reading from the books, like I can read a passage to you, but I think that would be quite, you know, tedious or boring. So talking like this, I find it more interesting, in my opinion. So as you know, that Smirnov has this fits problem since his childhood, and he is also very honest. And how then there is an example for this. Once Fyodor Pavlovich, you know, he is very careless, he is a debauchee, he doesn't have a character. He loses his 300 rubles in his house. He tries to find it, but he is unable to find it. So meanwhile, as it is night and Fyodor Pavlovich is sleeping, Smirnov finds it and he places the 300 rubles beside the bed of Fyodor Pavlovich, or on some table, I don't know where. But next morning, when Fyodor Pavlovich wakes up in the morning and he finds 300 rubles, and he comes to know that Smirnov found those 300 rubles and put this on his table. So Smirnov was rewarded by Fyodor Pavlovich by 10 rubles. But this is not the main point. The main point is that his honesty, as you can see that he is so honest. So this is one other trait of his personality. So Smirnov also goes to Moscow for his studies. He studies cookery there, like kind of hotel management, you can say that. And he was brilliant in his learning, but he was unable to make any friend because he used to spend most of his time alone. When he was at home, he rarely talked to anyone, and he was kind of a very gloomy and very depressing person who would restrict his thoughts to himself, and he would rarely venture to make any friends or venture to talk to anybody. Later on in his novel, he used to talk to Ivan in great depth. So that I won't discuss because I want to restrict my video particular to chapter 6 only. Let me see if there are any other points that I should discuss, but I have covered most of the points related to his personality. And he rarely laughs or shows any interest in anything, as I have already said this. And on top of it, he is extremely difficult to understand. He has this unique personality, this dark personality. I think if you read this book and if you come across this chapter, you will definitely go through this chapter again and again to grab his personality or to grasp his image in more detail, because his personality is extremely fascinating and it will leave you more confusing or more happier as well, because you will come across such personality, and this personality is, I think, the main jewel of this book. So for this video, I think I will take your permission. There are so many more things that I want to talk about, but how to talk when you have so many things and you want to restrict your video to some length, because if I keep on talking about this, it won't make much sense and I will lose the point altogether. So I have more points to cover. I will cover those points in my next videos. For now, I think take your time. I hope you are healthy. Keep exercising as well, because without exercise, life is a mess or a hell. It is one and the same things. So for now, give me your permission. I will be back with some other video. Thank you very much. If you are here at the end of this video, have a good day. Take care.